Hello my friends, it's Alex again. I've got lots of requests lately to do a tutorial on this awesome Space Zen animation. And today is your lucky day, I'm gonna show you how it was created. Okay, let's go! So, this animation has two parts. One is Suzanne firing her lasers, and second one is destruction of some space object I'll show you later in this video. Here I have first my project opened, and let me quickly show you around. I'll turn random preview and let's see the animation once more. So she's forming up her lasers, camera starts to slowly go back, and beams go near camera. Okay, now, what do we have here? Here's our Suzanne, and there's the object we're planning to destroy. She has lots of materials assigned to different parts of her head. If you go to solid mode, you can see I made some of her edges very sharp for subsurface modifier. They are displayed in magenta color. Okay, let's go back to materials. We have 7 in this list. Let me select faces they're assigned to. So the first one is Death Star material. It covers most of Suzanne, and here we have emission shader highlighting windows on spacecraft hull. If I switch to Shader Editor, we have 4 image textures here, for color, emission and 2 displacement maps. This shader mixes 2 types of hull surface, panels and windows, and I mask out panels using this node, Mask Mesh. Now, if you open it up, here we can see 3 brick textures mixed using Multiply node. Let me play with these values so you can see the layers we have here. Actually, we have 3 copies of the same node around here with slightly different values. You see what happens when I'm changing these sliders. Panels take more space over the whole surface. Let's go to the next one. Now, this node has slightly bigger values, and that way it expands beyond panel's texture. So I can multiply it over to add borders around panels. And here we have detail texture. I'm overlaying it with these 2 mixed nodes to add some color variation to the window's hull. This one is for color, and this one is for specular channel. I'll move the camera behind the Suzanne so you can see specular reflections better. Let's open it up, and here we have same Mask Mesh node to affect only this particular layer, and same Death Star textures but scaled up. See what happens if I change the scale? So I'm reusing the same texture to spice it up a little. By the way, let me open this texture so you can see how it looks like. So here it is, lots of vertical lines and a bit of grayscale noise. Now let's go back to the shader. Just let me move the viewport so we have a better picture. Okay, now here's the ambient occlusion node. It's a good thing in Eevee we can control that. And yeah, one more interesting node is down here. Detail bump. I'm mixing it with a very low factor, so it's barely noticeable at the moment. Here we have Death Star panel's texture and Mask Mesh node we already seen before. Let me show you that panel's texture as well. There you go. Okay, that's it for this shader. Let's move on. Next is her eyes shader. And it's much simpler than the previous one. And here we have just a couple of textures mixed in together. It's a Death Star eye texture, and some panels we also used in the hull shader. Let me show you the image. Now, you might be wondering, how did I map this to a circular shape? Let's go to the edit mode so you can see the unwrap. Here it is. I used cylinder projection to unwrap this eye circle. Now, this approach has one downside. I have highest resolution in the center where all circle edges merge, and on perimeter resolution is much lower. But it's barely noticeable from a distance. Okay, next is the cap shader. It's assigned on the top of the Suzanne's head. Kinda similar to the previous, just a few textures and panels. But here we also have cap top mask to make this circle on the top perfectly smooth. Now, without it we will have lots of distortions where UVs join. Now let me open this mask group, and here we have a color ramp which controls fade out of the mask. Watch closely what happens when I drag one of the color stops. You can see the distorted panel's texture showing through, and we don't want that. Let me show you the unwrap. Here at the top we have these triangles, and lots of texture distortions may happen here. For this cap's texture I have gradient already applied over, but here in the shader we also have panels mixed over. So that's why I wanted to mask them out at the top. Okay, now for the panels. I have this shade applied on the rims and around the eyes. So panel's shader is very similar to what I had in the eye shader. But now I'm just using panel textures with two additional node groups for finer details. Here I'm changing overlay factor. Let me move to a different place where it's more visible, and you can see these additional details appearing over panel's surface. Okay, that's it. Here's a second copy of this shader. It's mostly the same, but I have an additional multiply node here to make it darker. This shader is applied to seams in between hull panels. And finally we have two effect shaders here for laser beams and glow. Both shaders are animated. So dust glow is assigned to these little circles on perimeter of the eye, and I'll change timeline frames so you can see how they glow up. And laser shader is assigned to these thin rectangles coming from the perimeter and focusing at the center. Dot shader is just a mix of transparent and emission shaders with strength keyframed to grow from 0 to 1000 by frame 30. So that's how it starts glowing before firing lasers. Laser shader is a bit more complex, and here we have this wave effect, which is animated by keyframing phase offset parameter of a procedural wave texture right here. And this wave effect is masked by two linear gradients, one here for wave effect falloff, and another one here for the beam shape. Okay, but we also have a big laser beam right here, which appears only after frame 50, when all the 8 small lasers join at the focus point. It has the same setup, but slightly different gradients to make it brighter. But that's not all for the effects. We also have some particle emitters where these beams join. Here it is, laser particle emitter. If I go to the particle properties, you can see it's rigged to spawn tiny sparks starting from frame 50. Now, sad thing about particles in Eevee, they work best only with mesh particles. That's why we have here instance object set to laser particle. Now if I go select this laser particle in the outline and press numpad period to focus camera on it, we can see it's floating right here. Very simple mesh with shader which is very similar to what we had on laser globe circles. Now all the difference is the way how IUV unwrapped it. Let me show you. All mesh triangles are mapped to the same region, so they take a slice of the linear gradient generated in the shader. Just like laser beams, it has two perpendicular planes to look nice from any viewpoint. You might haven't noticed, but We also have a beautiful and fully procedural space background with lots of stars, clusters and nebulas. Let me show you real quick. It's built using lots of Voronoi and noise textures and some color ramps. I'll increase brightness here, so you can see it all the beauty. By the way, I have a nice step-by-step tutorial on how to create space backgrounds. Go check it out if you want to build something similar. Now here we also have a sun mesh with very powerful emission shader. I have bloom effect enabled in the render pipeline, and this is how I get this amazing glow around the sun. Very fast and handy how to do it without using volumetrics. One minor thing to keep in mind is that I disabled shadows in material properties so it doesn't cast them on the monkey. Now this thing right here. This is just a very simple mesh with a texture mapped over. I'll open UV editor to show you its layout. We'll come back to it later in the second project file. So, what else I have animated besides the shaders? If you go back here and switch to solid mode, you can see how objects are moving. First of all, Suzanne starts to rotate slowly by Z-axis at frame 50 or so. We can also see camera changing its focal length to zoom out and rotating around Suzanne in the opposite direction. I did this so we can see stars rolling in the background. And if I go back to the frame 50, we can see how laser beam is firing straight. This is done by changing its Z-scale rapidly in 10 frames or so. Now let's switch to the second project file. Here we have an exploding logo animation. Laser beams cross at the object, it glows up and explodes in thousands of pieces. So how is it done? Let me zoom out so you can see what's happening. We still have the same space Suzanne with two laser beams. It's animated to rotate and stop when the laser beams hit the target. This plane is an explosion video set up to start playback at about frame 300. If I select it and go to the shader editor, you can see I used color ramp to change its colors to have green tint. And also using its color channel pass through grayscale color ramp as an alpha when mixing emission shader with transparency. Here I can tweak emission power to make explosion brighter. Next, here where beams touch the logo, I have two animated particle emitters which start working at the exact moment when laser beam starts moving across. It spawns hundreds of particles, faking effect of beam melting the logo and leaving a trace on the surface. Then starts the logo glow up effect. I'll go back to the shader editor, and here I have an animated color mix node, which is blending green color over the emission channel, making it glow. It's just amazing how easy we can achieve such awesome effects just by animating some input fields. And after that, when explosion video is covering most of the logo, we have another particle emitter starting to spawn thousands of sparks from the volume of the mesh. I baked particle dynamics because it's very slow if playing in real time. So what's actually moving them? If I quickly delete the bake, here we have velocity randomized parameter, which is forcing all sparks moving randomly in all directions. Easy as that. After some moments when these sparks are covering logo, it starts to fade out. See, alpha parameter is animated as well, so in between frames 340 and 345, it disappears completely. And yeah, along with the particles animation, letters start to fly away as well. Nothing fancy here, I animated them manually. So if I select one of these letters, see, curves are very simple. just some keyframes on location and rotation. Now, there you go. Some awesome effects may seem very complex from the first glance, but can be done very easily if you know how to fake them. So have a nice day, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.